in nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sanctus.
Today I am going to examine a possible origin of what may be the cause behind the separation of cultures. Now this is a purely hypothetical idea that I am merely portraying into audio format to gauge the aspect of how plausible it sounds when laying out the details, so no one take this too seriously. The evolutionists have been split between many different origins as to where mankind came from. More specifically is the mystery that leads to the conclusion that our current species of Homo sapiens man are not direct descendants of the original mammalian man, mainly because of our genetic qualities that separate the Neanderthal man and the Homo erectus man from the current Homo sapiens man, which first was recorded to having fossilized remains about 13,650 years ago. Then there is a 40,000 year gap in which no human remains were found. Then it picks up with Neanderthal man and the younger Dryas Homo erectus man and their remains being present, but no sign of the Homo sapiens man of our species being found anywhere else, leaving archaeologists baffled as to where they came from somewhere within that 40,000 year time frame. In that time we genetically leapt with severe alterations both genetically and physically. These changes, which by our recorded timescale set by previous hybrids of the mammalian species, takes millions of years to develop the advancements that we did in the window of 40,000 years. In that time we developed our bendable thumbs, as models of the Neanderthal show that they could not twist their wrists and hands like we can and always walked around with their arms and hands in a flat position. They also were a species that moved at high speeds on all fours, whereas our skeletal structures are bipedal and designed to walk on two legs. Along with the physical alterations, there were also genetic advancements that are irregular, such as the Neanderthal and younger Dryas had one less chromosome than we do, which allows us to develop immunities to our natural environment much easier than they did, and our ability to absorb higher amounts of radiation than they could. But what is even more mysterious than this is there have been many geneticists that say there are definite signs of highly precise surgical augmentation that is at the base of this alteration to our genetic qualities that separate us from the other mammalian species. So with this all laid out, let me begin the hypothetical idea that begins by merging the evolutionists' theory of man first walking from the sea, evolving from the plasmodic origins within our ocean's waters during the dawn of our planet, and the mammalian descendants evolving from generation to generation some 500,000 years ago. Now let us place the Garden of Eden scenario into place somewhere within this 40,000 year period, along with the Nephilim bloodline tale I mentioned from the Zachariah section video, and what I surmise happened is that Adam was of the mammalian descent that had evolved from the reptilian and other mixed species on the surface, and Eve was of the species that had evolved within the ocean that began much like this coronavirus seems to act and mutate in its cellular mitosis process, evolving quicker and more complex with each species it acquires its genetic data from. When the amphibian species that has evolved from that process walked onto land and evolved into an air-breathing species. This spawned the one who would one day become Eve once they developed into a species that could reproduce with the mammalian man, and so the hybrid Nephilim species began, as well as the division of cultures, which in the end. This eventually led up to the event 300 million years ago, where we were saved by the Merkaba vessel during the flood of Noah's tale that occurred 300 million years ago. That the character of Noah in the tale was used to gather the genetic information that this ship stored within its databanks of all the animals' different species that were necessary for the synthesis of the cycle of life to flourish on this world, and that there may have been survivors that struggled to carry on but eventually perished, with the Neanderthal man being the last line of the mammalian man during the aftermath of the Mount Tabor eruption between 75,000 years ago to 40,000 years ago. Then around 13,650 years ago, the Merkaba ship returned after the ecosystem restabilized itself and began its genetic repopulation of mankind, leading to what the Jewish timeline of the world says to be when the ship began the event of the Garden of Eden, repopulating the planet with the species it had saved along with Adam, and even explains why they say there have been 9 attempts to create Adam, our species being the most recent endeavor to save the life on our world from extinction. Why? Because the true creator of all that is resides hidden within their ship's systems and instructs them to work his will from there. But this is all a speculative hypothesis.
Fucking ready.